Now we look at different education policies that were published, announced and implemented by Government of Pakistan from 1947 to 2019. So in the 1950s and 60s was the formative period. In 1947, literacy rate was around only 15%. And in numerous areas, it was in single digits, meaning thereby 5, 6 or 8%. For many women, for example, in Balochistan or Fatah, it was close to zero. So that was the condition or that was the circumstances in which Pakistan started to educate its people. Qaidazm was, of course, concerned about education even before independence. And even amidst of all the crises, you know, refugees coming and Kashmir issue and issue of division of resources between India and Pakistan and his ill health, he was concerned about education. And the first education conference was called only a few months after independence in 1947. And Qaidazm's message to that education conference was and this is a quote, "The importance of education and the type of education cannot be overemphasized. There is no doubt that the future of our state will and must greatly depend upon the type of education we give to our children." So that was the message of Qaidazm to the first educational conference held in 1947. So this conference promised free and compulsory primary education up to 5th grade, of course. Then it called for adult education because most of the 85% of the people were illiterate, and as well as not only illiterate but also adults. And it was against uniform methods and approaches. So it wanted a varied cluster of different methods adopted to reach the aim of universal primary education or universal literacy rate. In the 1951, a new national plan of educational development was announced. So it was the first deliberate and organized action plan. So the conference was there, it had some aims, but there was no action plan. So this was an action plan of how to improve education or how to increase education in Pakistan. So it called for 86,000 additional teachers. And it also called for more trained teachers. It also promised 24,000 new primary schools with a capacity of 3.7 million pupils. It also called for 2.8 million adults literate through V8 program. So V8 is Village Aid program, which was funded by the US. So and this program basically focused on agriculture, so improving the agriculture practices. So government thought that if we add with those vocational training related to agriculture, we add some basic math or basic English or basic Urdu, it will help. So it thought of using the village aid apparatus or infrastructure to improve or to increase literacy. But of course, this development plan failed due to lack of financial and institutional support in the later years. In the first five-year plan from 1955 to 60, it started 2.5 years late, but it promised 4,000 new schools, more trained teachers. But the unfortunate thing was that it was realized that most the literacy rate didn't increase in the 1950s. So it was around 16% at the start of 1950s, and it remained around 16% in the 1960s, at the end of 1950s. So there was, Ayub came and he established a new commission to revive or to improve the national education. So the report of the Commission on National Education came in 1959, and it called for not 5 years, but 8 years compulsory education. It called for a free and functionally literate people, and also called for adult education. And it thought that we will be able to have universal enrollment by in 15 years, that is 1975. Yeah. And it also called for nationalism, patriotism, and national languages. In the next report, it said that we are well aware that OERS is not the first set of proposals for reform of our education system. Our hope is that it may be the first to be translated in both prompt and long-term action. So this was the Education Commission's report, and this was written in 1959, but it is still true today. There have been lots of education policies since then in the last 72 years, but the reform is going on, but at a very slow pace. So we have the second and the third education 5-year plans. They also called for more schools, more female education, more adult education, more teaching aids, and enrollment rate from increase from 45% to 70%. But most of these reforms were never achieved because the funding was not there, the infrastructure was not there, the focus or priority of the government was not there. During the same period, Korea and many Asian countries spent a lot more on education. Pakistani government didn't spend much on education during this period. Thank you.